I'm so glad you could show up, but it's not Christmas party. Not party, it's Christmas play, as in P-L-A-Y?
Well, it's just when I heard Christmas, I started thinking about the presents, the food. Are you sure it wasn't a party? Because I was expecting presents.
Well, I know you were, but, you know, it's a Christmas play. See all these nice people out here? Say hi to them. Everybody say hi to Gus. Yeah, see, they're here to see the kids' Christmas play. And that's why I brought you here.
Oh, I see.
So, anyway, we're going to talk about Christmas isn't just about presents and getting gifts and food and cookies, is it? Well, you don't know that yet, right? So what Christmas is about, it's about a very, very special night. It's a night that God sent his only son down to earth as a baby. And the baby's name was?
Santa Claus! No, it was Santa Claus, right. He grew up and lived out of the presence of the world. That's not it?
No. See, Christmas is about the baby Jesus that was born. He would grow up, become the savior of the entire world. That's why I brought you here today. I want you to learn the true story of Christmas.
So, no cookies and no presents? You know, I really love Christmas cookies.
I know you do, but maybe we can have Christmas cookies later. Maybe. I'm promising. Are there any Christmas cookies out there? I don't see any. There is. Okay, well, good. Okay. But first of all, I want you to watch with all these nice people out here, and I want you to see if maybe, possibly, you can even learn something today. Okay?
Okay. Just save me some cookies.
Okay, well, be really quiet because now it's time to get started.
All right.
A long time ago, in a city of Nazareth, there was a girl named Mary. Mary was promised to marry a man named Joseph, who lived there too.
One day, an angel came and talked with Mary.
Wow, I didn't know angels could talk to people. How is that possible?
Well, just be quiet and listen. You'll learn.
Mary, you are going to have a baby. He will be called Jesus, the Son of God.
Oh, okay.
And the angel left.
Now that was a very short conversation. Should I go?
He will be. Just a minute.
Okay.
Now Joseph wasn't sure what to do when he heard that Mary was going to have a baby. So one night, While he was asleep, the angel came to talk to Joseph, too.
I see.
Joseph, wake up. Joseph, Mary is going to have a baby. It's okay for you to marry her and take care of her and the baby, who will be called Jesus, the Son of God.
And that is just what he did.
You would think they'd be a little bit more excited about this.
Well, yeah, you would, but you know. They are kids, they're actors.
Who is this dude? Isn't he overdoing it a little bit?
That would be the king, I believe. That's King Herod.
Can we continue?
Oh, go ahead.
The king, an evil man named Herod, said that everybody had to go to their own hometown to be counted.
Go to your hometown so I can count you all.
So Mary and Joseph were going to go to their hometown so they could be counted.
Oh, hey, I see them again. They're right there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there they go. Oh, there they go.
They're back.
They're walking kind of slow because they can slow down.
So Mary?
Like, seriously, like, they have to slide like 20 feet.
There were lots of other people there, too. There were so many people, in fact, that there was no room for them in the inn. So Mary and Joseph had to stay in a stable, which is a place where the animals stayed.
Wow, that couldn't have smelled very good.
Well, you know, there were probably cows there. And there were probably sheep. And maybe chickens, donkey, horse. Love the sound effects. They're good. Good job. Good job.
Excuse me, can we continue with the story?
Our bad.
Sorry. It's what I do.
While they were there, baby Jesus was born. Mary took him and wrapped him up warm and laid him in the manger. That night, there were some shepherds out in the fields outside Bethlehem, watching over their flocks.
I guess the sheep are moving a little slow tonight.
Yeah. I guess. I don't know. I'm not a sheep expert.
Really?
Yeah, maybe that's the best word for them. I don't know.
An angel came and talked to the shepherds, and they were terribly afraid.
She's back.
Yeah, look, she's back.
Is there only like one angel?
Don't be afraid, I bring great news. The Savior has been born in Bethlehem. You will find him wrapped in soft clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly, there was a heavenly host of angels.
Wow, that's a lot.
Suddenly, let's try this again. Suddenly, there was a heavenly host of angels.
The heavenly host, that's your cue.
And the angel said, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. And then the angels left.
So this baby was so special that the angels announced it.
Yes, very special. In fact, this baby was so special because he's the Son of God, and he would grow up one day and be the Savior of the entire world.
So, he's not delivering gifts, but that is one special baby.
That is. After the angels left, the shepherds went to the baby Jesus and found him lying in a manger, just like the angel said.
And when they found him, they worshiped him.
Thank you.
Later on, some wise men came to Jerusalem looking for the newborn King of the Jews. To know where this newborn king was.
Where is this newborn king? Go and find him that I can worship him like the king he is.
So the wise men went and found baby Jesus by following his star. And when they found him, they worshiped him.
What? I trust this guy.
They gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But King Herod really didn't want to worship the baby Jesus. He wanted to...
I knew it! He's a bad guy!
Can I please continue?
Sorry.
You're bad. You did it.
As I was saying, King Herod wanted to kill baby Jesus. But the wise men were warned by God about this. So after they saw baby Jesus, they left and went home another way.
Ooh, that's a relief.
When the king found out that he was tricked, he was really mad.
All right, I'm really mad.
He was determined to find and destroy this newborn king. So he sent his soldiers to Bethlehem to find and kill the baby Jesus.
Go find this baby and destroy him.
But God had another plan. Did you know, Gus? Are you worried? You look worried.
Sorry, I was frozen with that.
You were frozen with fear.
He was frozen with fear.
Can you see it?
If you let me continue, we'll find out what's going to happen.
Thanks.
But God warned Joseph in a dream to get out of there.
Joseph, get out of here.
And that is just what they did.
Here comes this guy.
Oh no, can't find him.
This can't be good.
No.
Did you find him?
Not exactly.
I'm not happy that I'm supposed to be as my royal subject.
Let me do. Nice sentence. Is he ever happy?
Shut off your head.
That's not nice.
Not very nice.
And so Mary and Joseph and the little baby Jesus went to Egypt, and they stayed there until the evil king died.
That's really super awesome.
Very dramatic. Like, how did you get that? yes, I do. It's awesome!
Excuse me. Thanks. After King Herod died, God told Joseph it was safe to come back because the people who wanted him dead had now died.
It's safe. You can come back now.
Hey, Blunt.
Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus came back from Egypt, and they went to live in the town of Nazareth again. And that's where baby Jesus grew up until he was grown. So now you've heard it all, how God sent his only son, Jesus, to be born as a baby so that later he would save everyone from their sins. And all it took was
just a little Christmas.
I think I get it now.
God gave us the greatest gift of all. So at Christmas, it should be about giving, not getting. And the best gift we can give is ourselves.
Right.
I feel a spark of love.
You want to sing along?
Sure, why not?
Mountains ring out with angelic